Lord God sanctioned slavery, period. We don't have to like it. I don't like it. Sometimes I feel like I'm a slave to my wife, you know. I don't like it. Does anybody else like it? We don't like it. But Lord God did sanction slavery. He sanctioned it. Black History Month, we shout in March. But God allowed, God permitted slavery. Ain't that something? So slavery is not sacrilegious. It is not inhumane for one person to own another according to the will of God in those days. If it was, then Father God was inhumane himself, and God is not even a human, and he is, so he doesn't have the right to try to be humane. And it's right here in our Bible. The question, however, is the purpose for slavery and the treatment of one slave as God ordained. Now look down at verses 48 through 54. 48 through 54. Now, if you got a Bible, I want everybody to read this out aloud. Don't just look up. I want you to help those read because my wording is different. So if you got King James, I want you to look down at your Bible and read it with me. Ready? Read. Read it out. Verse 50, read on. Read on. Now, what I want you to do is stop right there, and I'm going to line everything that you read. You just put brackets on the outside of it, so you refer to it later. Isn't that amazing that God will say something like this? He says, even if some of your Israelites become so much in debt that they may want to sell themselves to foreigners in your country, you still have the right to be set free by a relative, such as a brother or an uncle or a cousin or some other family member. In fact, if you ever get enough money, you may buy your own freedom by paying your owner for the number of years that you would still owe him as a slave before the next year of celebration. The longer the time until then, the more you will have to pay. And even while you are the slaves of foreigners in your own country, your people must make sure that you are not mistreated. Somebody say, not mistreated.
Not mistreated.
Now, does that sound like the same kind of slavery that you heard about in the United States? No. Because if you didn't do what you should have done, they would take bullwhips or whatever the case is and beat you like an animal. That is not the kind of slavery God was talking about. That was not the kind of ownership. That is not the way God wanted people to be treated. Although he did allow slavery or servitude or being owned by another person and willed by another person for the sake of a debt that is owed. If you cannot gain your freedom in any of these ways, both you and your children will still be set free in the year of celebration, better known as the year of Jubilee. People of Israel, I am the Lord your God, and I brought you out of Egypt to be my own servants. And so if I'm God, what I say rules. You will be set free during the period of Jubilees, beginning at the very first verses of chapter 25. So what was the kind of slavery that God allowed? God allowed the kind of slavery that hey, you are a servant of mine, I don't pay you, you work for me. I own you, I own your service, but I must be good to you, I gotta be kind to you, I cannot mistreat you, I cannot abuse you as a human, because both you and I belong to God. And at the end of the servitude period that God has judged, I have to release you whether you got money to pay for it or not, which means that every Jubilee year or at the every 50th year, which the Bible just talks about here, you must be released. Right here in chapter 25, verse 10, this 50th year is sacred. It is a time of freedom. Somebody say freedom. And of celebration, when everyone will receive back their original property and slaves will return home to their families free. Now, is that the kind of freedom that God talked about? No. See? So what God is saying here, yes, God just sanctioned slavery, and when we leave it, we can't just be saying, well, y'all did us a misservice because you all own us. They have a right to own us. God sent you that people can long for. It's a hard pill to swallow, but God's got a reason for everything that God allowed. Think about this. How many of you black folk in here are glad to be in America? Yes, sir. No, I want to see your hands. Yes, sir. How many black folk are glad to be here? Now, I know about this God, and some of the other guys want to take everybody back to Africa and everything like that, and I think that's a great thing. But how many folk really love this country to the point that you want to stay here? Now, isn't it sad how we got here? But because we got here and changed, does anybody in here say, well, I didn't come the way I wanted to, so I'm going back? I just thought I'd throw that out there, Billy. Here's the deal. Who knows the mind of God that they can instruct him? Why did God allow people to own people? I have no idea. All I know is that God's ways are higher or greater or more in depth than our ways. We cannot figure God out, why God allowed it, and why God put it in his law that one man could own or emancipate another human being, but God did. I wonder if it's got anything to do with sin. So got quiet up in here. And we say, well, free at last, free at last. Thank God. Yes, praise God, we're free. But at what cost was our freedom? And when God brought us to where we are now, why did we have to start where we started in order to get where we are now? What was God up to when God allowed slavery from the beginning? Not just for us, but for everybody else who was ever a slave for some of us.
Jesus. All right.
It's something to think about, isn't it? Let me move because I got to get you out of here. I know you got a little service. Now watch this. Slaves were not to be mistreated, abused, or killed, and all slaves were to be freed during the year of Jubilee or the 50th year of the Jewish calendar. So slavery was not to be a permanent act. Now, back to the curse of Ham by his father. Look at Genesis chapter 9. You going to hang with me?
Yeah.
Look at Genesis 9. Take it up with God. Look at verses 24 and 25. I want you to read so it'll wake you up. Look at verses 24 and 25. This is interesting to me. Now, verse 24 and 25 in the King James Version. Let's read it together. Ready? Read.
And all from his mind.
And what?
And his son has done unto him. And he said, curse be Canaan, a servant of servants. He shall be the
end. Notice that Noah put the curse on his son. Who put the curse on his son?
Noah.
Noah put the curse on his son. Who put the curse on his son?
Noah
put the curse on his son. Not God. Somebody say, not God.
Not God.
Which means that God did not curse anybody. Not into slavery. Noah, the Bible says, cursed Ham. God didn't curse Ham. Whoever Ham's descendants are, God didn't curse me, curse them. Noah curses on son. Nothing that man does is permanent. Only God is everlasting. Noah prayed in verse 26 for God's permission, but God did not curse Ham. So the descendants of Ham, whoever they are, and wherever they are in the world, are not under a curse by God, nor did God curse them even to this day. And even 200 years ago, or back in 1865 and beyond, 1865, the signing of the Emancipation Proclamation, which disallowed any man to emancipate another human being. He must emancipate all of his own people. God never cursed anybody into permanent slavery. So I guess, you know, when we get back here, we're going to be talking about where is your mind? Particularly us in small towns, who have small towns mentality. Where is your mind? I'll get back to that later. Now, the son Noah cursed Ham. Now the son Noah cursed, who was Ham, who, I wrote a question here, who are his descendants and what part of the world did they create nations? Notice now Genesis chapter 10 beginning at verse 6 and listen to me. So who are these descendants of Noah or of Ham, the cursed one? Who are the descendants of Ham and what nations did they form? Let's see if it was black folks only that was cursed. Under this curse. Y'all with me?
Yeah.
Okay, now watch this. Look at verse 6. Don't you be leaving it talking about no black power with no matches and stuff. Now watch this. The descendants of Ham. Watch this. Verse 6, beginning there, Luke 20. You listen to mine. Okay, so you can look at me or you can underline it. Ham's descendants have their own languages. their own tribes and land. They were, listen, Ethiopia, Egypt, Put, Canaan. Cush was the ancestor of Sheba. You know, the E has the A sound, the A has the R sound. Havilah, Sabah, Rama, Sateka. Rama was the ancestor of Sheba and Dedan. Cush was also the ancestor of Nimrod. Somebody say Nimrod.
Nimrod.
And on the line of this, he was a mighty warrior, watch this, whose strength came from the Lord. Nimrod is the reason for the saying, you hunt like Nimrod with the strength of the Lord. Nimrod first ruled in Babylon, Erech, and Akkad, all of which were in Babylon. From then, Nimrod went to Assyria, somebody say Assyria, and built the great city of Nineveh. Somebody say Nineveh. He also built Rehoboth, and Kala, as well as Rezin, which is between Nineveh and Kala. Egypt was the ancestor of Ludum, and so forth, and so forth, and so on. Now watch this. Canaan's sons were Sidon and Hey. He was also the ancestor of the Jebusites, listen, the Amorites, listen, the Gergesites, the Hivites, the Archites, the Sinites, and all them other ites. Later, the Canaanites spread from the territory, watch this, of Sidon, and went as far as Gaza. And we all know where Gaza is, right? And they fight over there now, in the direction of Gera. They also went as far as Lasha in the direction of Sodom, Gomorrah, Adma, and Zebulun. Now listen to me. Notice now. Nimrod, the mighty warrior, got his strength from whom?
The Lord.
He got it from God. Nimrod, this great guy. Everybody know about the story about Nimrod. Got his power from God, his strength from God. So why would God give strength to a mighty person, to a person to be mighty rather, at any time, and then be cursed by God into slavery? Why would God say, I'm going to bless you to be a strong warrior and then curse you into slavery? You hear what's happening? Hey, let me just, can I have just a little bit more of your time? Why would God curse you and then bless you?